私は霊ではない。死神だ。
私の力を注ぎ込む。死神になれ。
イチゴに力を貸し与えた死神、クチキルキア。
貴様には死神代行として死神の仕事を手伝ってもらう。
どうするつもりです。死神の力の受け渡しは死刑に値します。
その男を殺せ。
さもなくばルキア、貴様が死ぬ。
どうすんだよ、ルキア。
さらばだ、イチゴ。
君、死神か。僕の存在に気づいていなかったようだね。
死神の存在を知る謎のクラスメイト、石田ウリュウ。
死神よりクインシー一族の方が優れているということを証明してみせる。
クインシ
ー。僕は君が死神である以上戦わなければならない。
黒崎一護、高校生兼死神代行。
死神になれ。悪霊ホロを倒すことができるのは死神だけ。
やってやろうじゃないか。この俺が倒してやるよ。目の前で困ってる奴をほっとこうとはクズでもね。
俺が守る。
イチゴ、
この戦いだけは絶対負けらんねえ。
Okay, martial arts movie fans, I've got some interesting facts on Bruce Lee. Did you know that when editing movies starring Lee, the editors had to slow his action scenes down so people could see what he was doing? Now, Lee also had bad eyesight, and it's one of the reasons he appreciated Wing Chun's contact style of movement, because he could rely more on touch than sight. The actor also voiced most of the English voices in his films. Yep, all the English-speaking guys in Way of the Dragon, apart from the mighty Chuck Norris, and his other Hong Kong films released before Enter the Dragon, were voiced by the main man himself.
I have a bonus fact for you about none other than Jean-Claude Van Damme. Now, sources have that Van Damme turned down the role of Johnny Cage in Mortal Kombat to star in Street Fighter. The irony is the Mortal Kombat game was initially developed as a Jean-Claude Van Damme video game, and Johnny Cage was modeled after his portrayal of Frank Dux in Bloodsport. Had he taken the role, Jean-Claude Van Damme would have been playing a portrayal of himself, portraying another martial artist. Wow, how confusing. For all you martial arts fans, I have some interesting facts on Jackie Chan. Being one of the greatest action heroes of all time, it's not surprising to know that he really does all of his own stunts, and they have cost him. While Chan was shooting the accidental spy, his tailbone was hit so hard that it caused temporary partial paralysis. His worst accident by far, which was a near-death experience, was caused by a pretty mundane stunt, jumping onto a tree. He missed the tree and hit the rocky ground head first. That resulted in a piece of his skull being cracked and going into his brain, and he had blood pouring from his ears. Chen had to have an 8-hour emergency brain surgery, which obviously was successful, and now has a permanent hole in his head secured with a plastic plug. Martial arts fans, you know him as Tony Jaa, but did you know his real name is Japanum Yerum and that his parents are elephant herders? Jaa became fascinated by the world of martial arts after watching movies as a young kid. His main influences have come from Jackie Chan, Jet Li and Bruce Lee, stating they are his masters and that what they did was so beautiful, so heroic, that he wanted to do it too. He practiced until he could do the moves exactly as he had seen the masters do it. Bruce Lee was a heavy fighter who threw hard punches. Jackie moves very fast and uses a lot of comedy. And Jet Li is very fluid. He has tried to combine all of their styles and added some things of his own to create his own unique style. Fighting is without a doubt the oldest form of competition that mankind has ever engaged in. And nowhere is appreciation for the beauty of fighting more apparent than in martial arts cinema. So let's celebrate the genre with the following top 10. Coming in at number 10 is Iron Monkey from 1993, the quintessential Hong Kong martial arts film of the 90s, starring Donnie Yen and Yu Rongguan. Number 9 is Tony Jaa's Tom Yam-gun, also known as the Protector from 2005. At number 8 is Five Element Ninjas, or Chinese Super Ninjas from 1982, directed by Chan Che. This movie is as crazy as Kung Fu gets, but you've got to love it for its entertaining excesses. Jackie Chan's best movie by far comes in at number 7, Drunken Master 2, also known as The Legend of Drunken Master from 1994. Number 6 is Ang Lee's Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, and number 5 is Crippled Avengers from 1978, directed by Chan Che. Number 4 is Sui Hark's masterpiece Once Upon a Time in China, starring Jet Li. Bruce Lee's most essential film, Enter the Dragon, is at number 3, and number 2 is The 36th Chamber of Shaolin, starring Gordon Liu. And what you have all been waiting for, coming in at number 1 on our list, is 1978's Five Deadly Venoms from director Chen Chen. It's everything that's wonderful about martial arts movies, beautiful choreography and timeless stories of good versus evil. So what do you think? Do you agree with our list? Let me know in the comments below, and remember to subscribe to our channel for all the best martial arts action movie releases.